Throughout history, we have designed and developed technologies to further our exploration capabilities, both within our home planets and across the vast expanse of space. In this season of An Interloper's Guide, we will explore technology inspired by the natural world and meet some of the creatures responsible for our own technological advancements. If you are enjoying this series, remember to like and comment on the video to let the crew know. Welcome to An Interloper's Guide to Biomimicry, Radioactive Wastelands. It is a common misconception that exposure to radiation is inherently dangerous. We are at all times subjected to some form of it within the natural world. If improperly harnessed, radioactivity of any kind can indeed prove deadly. Yet, with proper handling, it has helped us accomplish some of our greatest technological advancements to date. This is Akyo 51/P3, the Nuenning System's supercritical planet. Its extremely radioactive surface is regularly plagued by irradiated downpours that intensify the already high levels of ionizing radiation in its atmosphere. These dusty wastelands are home to 10 animal species, the strangest of which lives exclusively within the planet's skies. Bidamoe, a unique member of the Protocaeli genus. Their translucent bodies, less than a meter in length, make them difficult to spot amongst the planet's radioactive haze. Bidamoe travel in small tight-knit flocks of up to 5 individuals and are active throughout the day and night, seeming to never need sleep. The bizarre appearance of these creatures is accentuated by their unusual method of travel. Bidamoe do not fly, well, at least not in conventional terms. Rather than relying on air currents, Bidamoe manipulates ion radiation within the planet's atmosphere to facilitate their flight. A specialized membrane absorbs and distributes ion particles at a high rate, enabling Bidamoe to hover effortlessly in the sky without being affected by air currents. This design has been applied to Exocraft technology, resulting in the development of one of the most effective exploration vehicles ever built. The Nomad. What makes this vehicle so revolutionary is its unique ability to traverse any terrain, including the surface of water. Like the Bidamoe species that inspired its design, the Nomad flies by manipulating ion radiation within the atmosphere. Small circular thrusters arranged in pairs at the front and back of the craft redirect particles downward at a high speed, allowing the vehicle to hover a few feet above any given surface. Whereas Bidamoe sources ion radiation from the surrounding environment, the Nomad draws upon stored radioactive particles that are contained within highly specialized batteries. Thanks to this clever biomimicry, planetary exploration has become more accessible, the Nomad serving as the perfect scout vehicle for any expedition. Across the galaxy within the Widraik region of galactic hub space, another creature has helped shape the advancement of modern exploration technology. This is Temethyo Prime, a supercritical planet found within Hub 7-11b, the Infantry system. Large clouds of radon gas, invisible to the naked eye, move across the planet's surface, uncovering expansive deposits of radioactive uranium hidden beneath its dusty soil. Despite the lethal concentrations of ionizing radiation within the planet's atmosphere, Temethyo Prime supports a busy ecosystem of both plants and animals. Like Akyo 51/P3, this supercritical planet is home to a unique member of the Protocaeli genus. Tigerucnima. Reaching lengths of up to 2.7 meters, the species navigates the skies with surprising grace and dexterity, able to outpace the planet's other airborne species. In their wake, a trail of blue gas follows their progress across the planet, an adaptation that allows members of the herd to easily find each other, even when visibility is poor. Using specialized gills, Tigerucnima passively harvest ionized particles from the planet's atmosphere, later releasing them in short bursts to maintain their flight. As these particles are released, they mix with waste materials from the creature's plant-based diet, resulting in a distinct blue coloration. Tigerucnima's unique propulsion method had a significant impact on the jetpack industry, helping to improve utility and performance twofold. The creature's harvesting technique has been implemented within jetpack propulsion, allowing jets to recharge from background radioactive particles in the atmosphere, rather than from ion batteries as in earlier models. This revolutionized the jetpack industry, negating the need for an internal energy source, subsequently lowering manufacturing costs and carry weight. With these advancements quickly becoming industry standard, interlopers can now use jetpacks for extended durations, increasing exosuit mobility capabilities tenfold. The coloration of Tigerucnima's propulsion trails has also inspired an array of unique cosmetic upgrades, allowing interlopers to customize the color of their exosuit's jetpack trails. This upgrade has utilization in planetary exploration, enabling teams to remain in visual contact with each other during extreme weather events, just like the Tigerucnima species. Interlopers looking to purchase these upgrades can do so at the Anomaly or from space station vendors. Mobility plays such an important part when exploring unfamiliar and dangerous terrain, and good movement is key to survival in many situations. By studying how creatures use radioactivity to move, we have expanded our understanding of its potential, enabling us to conceive more energy-efficient vehicles, tools, and protection technologies. Join us next episode as we explore the quiet, frigid lands of frozen tundras, uncovering specialized adaptations of the native creatures that have inspired technology today. Thank you for watching, and as always, have fun, stay safe, and most importantly, be curious.